Welcome and thank you for joining the webinar today. I'm Amanda Jadro, the Director of Portfolio Management at TRICOM. As an administrative and financial solutions provider to the staffing and consulting industry, it is our philosophy to be an active member of the staffing industry by staying abreast of the ever-changing marketplace. For that reason, TRICOM was pleased to launch the Industry Insider webinar series designed to share our expert knowledge and resources with our fellow staffing industry colleagues. One of our core values is to build relationships and become a leading resource to staffing and consulting firms nationwide. Our presenters today are Gary Pierce and Alex Chilow with Acclaimant. Acclaimant is a workforce and process automation platform for safety and risk managers. By combining safety, risk, and analytics into one connected workflow platform, Acclaimant empowers organizations to take control of their total cost of risk. Gary is the chief architect at Acclaimant, where he oversees insurance partner relationships, new product development, and acts as a resource for the Acclaimant team and their customers to better understand risk. Gary spent more than 20 years as the chief risk compliance and security officer at Kelly Services. Alex is the head of partnerships at Acclaimant, where he cultivates and manages the day-to-day relationships with enterprise customers, distribution channels, and industry partners. Prior to Acclaimant, Alex is the head of business development at an insurance brokerage firm based in Chicago. Workflow and automation platforms are becoming more relevant and prevalent in the risk management organizations, large and small. In today's Industry Insider webinar series, Gary and Alex will explore how workflow and process automation platforms can be used to reduce paper and time waste, enhance reaction speed, and empower organizations to become the best-in-class risk managers. We'll walk through specific examples of the best practices in the staffing industry, how pilots and creating milestones drive meaningful process toward change, and why productive discomfort can help every organization achieve great results. The presentation includes firsthand feedback from Gary and as the former Chief Compliance and Security Officer at Kelly Services and a recent future author for Risk Management Magazine. The learning objectives and webinar takeaways include what workflow and process automation platforms are and how they apply to risk management, why getting your process tools in place is a critical enabling building block for creating a next generation risk management organization, how to think about scoping a system and project, applying workflow technology to specific key risks, implementation best practices and what to look for in a partner. If you have any questions during today's presentation, please utilize the Q&A or the chat feature. After the presentation, there will be time for questions. With that, I will turn the floor over to Gary and Alex.
Excellent. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Amanda, for the great introduction, and thank you for the TRICOM team. Always excited to work with industry partners. Like TRICOM, where, again, they're also bringing solutions and industry insights into the world of staffing. So super excited to be presenting today. Directly, we're going to run through, as we discussed, our really focus is how to bring technology and leveraging technology to manage risk in real time. So right now, as we had the introductions, speaking right now is Alex Chilow. I run our partnership team here at Acclaimant. As Amanda mentioned, I call myself a recovering broker. I was on the insurance agency side for a number of years, focusing on running their new business development operations. And then we've also got Gary on the line as well. We're going to be tag teaming this presentation as we go through it directly here. Perfect. So as we go down, leveraging technology to manage risk in real time. To give everyone a little bit more background at Acclaimant, really what we're focused on here is we build workflow and process automation tools to streamline the entire risk management process for staffing firms. So today, and the reason why we actually got started in the industry, Our co-founder, Michael Schultz, is running a work comp captive for the staffing industry and realized really, hey, if my members of this work comp captive need to file an incident or a claim, either if that's workers' compensation, general liability, property, auto, down the line on the commercial P&C side, why are people still sending in faxes? Don't understand who the appropriate parties to send it to. So I took that little nugget of lessons learned, heavy, deep industry staffing experience, and said, let's put everything on an app. Today, now we released an entire risk reduction platform, as I mentioned, to really streamline everything from workplace safety, loss control, incident, and claims management all into one digital tool. Today, we're going to be talking about leveraging technology to manage risk in real time as we go through. Really, our premise here from the beginning, nobody cares about your business more than you do. I think, you know, from this aspect, safety, risk management, and loss control are at the really the forefront of making sure, again, not only are employees safe, we're sending employees to safe environments is the real focus. Risk is really getting more complex, pervasive, and threatening than ever before. There's a ton of litigation out there. There's things where if items are dropped, things aren't filed, opportunity to really not have control and focus over the business from that risk complexity standpoint. Today, also, you're focusing on growing your business. Extremely important. We see it through M&A on the staffing side, or we see it on the organic growth. These have all the increases in temp labor out there. So as you grow, insurance costs not only will correlate to your loss experience, but also correlate directly to your bottom line and your profitability as a business. So as you continue to grow, you're going to continue to encounter a broader spectrum of risk than in the past, if that's by new states you're going into, different compliance requirements. A lot of them sometimes might not be insurable as you go through. So making sure, again, you have a hyper-focus as you're expanding, as you're growing, making sure that you have controls and the proper procedures in place. Our mission at Claimant is to help protect and grow your business by empowering you to be more efficiently identify and manage that risk from a day-to-day basis. So as I mentioned, risk is everywhere, really from intellectual capital, social capital, financial capital, human capital. Staffing firms today have inherent difficulties in really controlling that risk. So for example, you have employees at job sites where staffing firms don't have a direct control and have very, very, very minimal amount of direct supervision. Extremely high turnover, both from the employee and the assignment side, so from the client side. Again, and also different specific applicants are only there for a small period of time. So again, everywhere you go, you know, risk is everywhere, and making sure that you identify these certain risks as you're going through your day-to-day is going to be extremely helpful to continue to stay profitable and grow that business organically.
Thank you, Alex.
So I'll hand over to Gary to talk about some of the new aspects that we're seeing out there today from a risk standpoint.
Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you, Alex. And Amanda, thank you again for having us today. I apologize to everybody on the line for my ragged voice. I'm just getting over a little bit of a cold here. But you know, Alex mentioned that as you grow, you're going to take on more risk. I would take that even further and say that even if you aren't growing, you're facing risks that you didn't face before. Risk as a matter of life is growing faster than the top line of the typical staffing company. It is indeed a new world out there. I look back over my early career in staffing, and I've been in staffing for literally 26, 27 years. And way back when, if you had workers' comp and time card fraud and thefts and the occasional auto accident under control, you probably had your risk perspective pretty well buttoned up. That's not true anymore. And a lot of it is if we take a step back, the very relationship between business and society is changing. And that, in large part driven by technology, is creating a more complex risk environment. And technology is enabling a social aspect and a communication aspect that simply did not exist anymore. And because of the political polarization in the meantime, the regulatory environment is becoming more difficult as well. I looked at the Detroit newspaper today and noted that the state of Michigan is proposing a new so-called overtime rule. The overtime rule governs when you have to pay people overtime as opposed to treating them on a salary basis. The feds are raising the threshold from 23,000 to about 35,000 next year, but a bunch of states think that that's inadequate and are taking that into their own hands. That is but one example of many of the fact that the regulatory environment is becoming much more complex. And if you are operating in multiple jurisdictions, keeping up with regulatory risk is a much bigger deal than it used to be. But as we turn the page, setting that aside, there's a long list of risk issues. I won't read all of these to you, but I will tell you that each and everything on this page is an issue I dealt with multiple times, and I'll bet many of you have dealt with many of the things on this page. If you haven't, you are at risk of doing so. It's interesting that on the TRICOM homepage, you'll find a news item that reports on a major airline settles a Fair Credit Reporting Act claim for $2.3 million. I can tell you I was involved in an even bigger Fair Credit Reporting Act claim in my time in the staffing industry, and it's very much a technical violation. But it's just one of a very long list of risks, not limited just to the things on this page. There are plenty of others. Screening issues, robocalls, text messaging, stored records, business continuity, privacy, pay equity, you name it. It's just a very long list. And again, as I said a moment ago, the magnitude and spectrum of risk is getting more concerning, more complex, more complicated at a faster rate than you're probably growing as a firm. Meanwhile, there are other risks that you may or not know they exist. If we can jump the page, Alex, thank you. If you look at this list, the earlier things on this slide are things where sooner or later, if you have a problem, you're going to find out about it because something is going to go wrong and someone's going to bring forth a claim or an incident to you. But as you go further down the list, the latter things on this slide do not necessarily have an external trigger. They are things that can cause a permanent performance drag for your organization, can cause you to be less profitable than you could be, can put your business at risk. But they're examples of things where no one's going to come and say to you, look, you've got a problem here. There's things you kind of have to figure out for yourself. So the risk spectrum is such that some things can cost you a lot of money out of pocket, but there are others where there isn't necessarily that external trigger. And so in that environment, we have to take risk into our own hands, and we need new ways of dealing with it.
Excellent. Thank you, Gary. And again, you know, from that standpoint, as we mentioned, the number of risks on that specific list. So really what happens when a risk isn't managed? You've got a number of different issues to initially think about. From the aspect of, you know, specifically your number one asset, unhappy employees. If you have unhappy employees, if employees don't understand when something does happen in the workplace that the culture from around the company is going to protect them and continue to bring them through the process, that you're going to really have a struggle from that cultural aspect and that safety and risk management philosophy. So making sure, again, we're keeping employees safe. At the same time, if it's not managed, you are going to have certain unhappy employees from that perspective. Also, there's going to be you're going to be less competitive on new jobs. So if that's acquiring a new specific client, if your specific modification rate from a work comp perspective is a high mod, as we like to say, that, again, you're not going to be able to actually win new business and gain new customers. So our focus and making sure from a collaborative perspective is that you're continuing to focus there, be more competitive, making sure then you develop that safety culture internally. And then on the third piece, really that higher cost. So when risk is not managed, you are going to have very exponentially higher cost in insurance and claims that you're going to be needing to manage on a day-to-day basis. At the end of the day, the focus from that staffing firm is to make sure, again, that they are profitable. They have profitable clients. They are continuing to grow, even if they're not continuing to grow, but making sure, again, you have those insurance and claims all managed. If you don't, you're going to see a big uptake and fairly quickly during that time. So when, you know, risk isn't managed as well, continued, that's really going to stifle your company growth. You're going to see where you can't actually continue to do new business. You're going to have issues on gaining new customers and clients. From that, there's also huge unrecognized drags, as we call it, from a productivity standpoint. If, for example, one of your recruiters is actually out and having to manage an employee that is injured and they're doing it all by paper process, it actually takes them 2 days out of productivity from them actually doing their job and recruiting and bringing in new business. Very making sure, again, that you have that hyper-focus on that drag, because it's something that's not recognized in a direct cost, but as you see, it's something that, from a soft cost perspective, definitely important to focus on. You're going to have a lot of wasted time, a lot of back and forth, a lot of different follow-ups, not only between the executive team, but also between the corporate risk management team, safety team, and then also employees out in the field. It's also a large distraction. If there's potential litigation, if there's items where you have to stop doing your day-to-day, because you have to go actually manage this manual, mundane process, there's going to be a lot of issues from a distraction perspective. Also, a ton of different hidden costs. So as you're going through, is that legal costs? Is that different OSHA fines, potentially? Is that compliance fines? Something that is not being focused on today at a lot of the staffing firms, but also needs to be incorporated because that's affecting the entire risk management functionality of the business. And then you'll have your excessive administration costs. So either if it's you need to hire more additional employees, do all the follow-up tasks, also to really manage the day-to-day, there's going to be a lot of administration costs on making sure you're continuing to play that catch-up. Also, if you don't have a focus on and managing it on a day-to-day basis, you're going to have an inability to turn the data into risk insights. That's really our focus here at Honeyman, and with any other process automation tool, is really helping turn data into usable data. If it's not managed appropriately, you can't see and you don't have that transparency across the organization. There's really going to be no more benchmarking or evidence of good and bad performance, so you don't have that standard or status quo where you understand, hey, this is actually not a piece of business that we want to go and work with because of the risk exposure. If you don't start somewhere and have that data and benchmark, you're not going to continue to get better. You're going to have a substandard product and service quality. There's going to be indirect costs of workplace injuries. So again, as I mentioned, different potential legal fees, doctor's visits for the specific employee, also a lot all relates back up to a lot of that lost productivity. And then also supply chain vulnerabilities from that standpoint. Couple key observations, you know, that we're seeing, and the correlation to here, as Gary was talking about it on the previous slide, is really technology is creating new risks. Either if that's, you know, from the social media aspect, if that's from people having access to a lot more information, technology is evolving, and the company needs to evolve as well. Also, in that same instance, technology can be a part of that response to the predicament. Technology can be that driving cost for the business, really helping reduce the necessary just to keep that up with the competition and the risk management function. So again, fighting technology with technology and helping alleviate some of those increasing new risks with also making sure that we have a lot higher visibility into our day-to-day business. So from that, go to how do best organizations really manage their risk? So taking this from an aspect of, as you see here on the top, three buckets, workplace safety, incident, and claims management. We talk about workplace safety. It's a big topic today at staffing firms, especially on the light industrial side and blue-collar work. Again, focusing on, one, having a streamlined safety functionality that you are not placing your employees, the number one asset of your company, into an unsafe environment. So finding ways, again, to use technology to make sure that either if it's from an on-site observation, if it's from a visit to that specific new client site, ways to make sure we're not sending employees in harm's way. A really focus on streamlining the entire incident management process, all the way from the initial triage directly from the client sites or your branches across the country, all the way into the workflow process internally at corporate, is a big function and workflow going through the entire incident to the resolution process as quickly as possible. And then you have your claims management piece, really focusing on creating more transparency into the data portion, understanding, hey, where are claims happening? Are our claims happening at certain client sites, our certain branches, certain regions, certain cities? Having the capabilities to drill down, and then also have that aggregate level across the entire enterprise. So by reporting, documenting, managing, and then having the analytics function is allowing best-in-class organizations manage this day-to-day through technology. So today, thanks to user-friendly technologies, as you see on the picture on the left-hand side, safety and claims, risk management, HR professionals today are one of the highest producers of paper at a business. So again, if that's filling out on-site observations, if that's filling out by hand incident reports, keeping that incident file or that claims file at someone's desk in a manila folder, is really yesterday. Today, people are using this functionality to really streamline it all the way from a mobile device, also from a web application directly in a system so that you have all visibility, data is all tagged and structured, and then you can actually operate your business from that command center when you don't have a robust risk management department or you want to make them a lot more efficient during this process.
So if we look at the picture that Alex just showed, traditionally technology has been used in risk management functions first and foremost to record claim activity. That is after the fact activity. But the truth is that claims are a symptom of a larger problem. If we think into the staffing business, we all know that in a tight labor market, if you have low pay rates, you're going to experience high employee turnover, which is going to send your recruiting costs through the roof. Similarly, if you have claim experience, it is going to drive a number of other costs that can multiply and get ahead of you very quickly. And you can see on this list some examples of those. In my experience, customers who are uncooperative and who were substandard from a safety partnership perspective tended to be substandard in other areas as well. But adverse events can ruin customer relationships. What we are talking about is a preemptive technology that will allow us to prevent problems before we get into this multiplication situation. The other thing it'll do is it'll free up your team to get more work done. Go ahead a page if you would, Alex. Thank you. So incidents are enormous distractions, but the distraction part often does not get measured because it isn't an out-of-pocket expense. But you can spend a tremendous amount of time, even if you don't lose a customer. In all of the activity required to just administer cases, people who handle these typically are not expert. They have a different day job. They don't know the drill. They have to depend upon instructions. They have to go ask around how to get things done. But again, a creative technology use can forestall a lot of this by making things automatic.
Exactly. And as Gary mentioned, really leverage technology to win the war on risk, because your risk is your business is really the focus here. So a few items as we're continuing to go down the process of the challenges facing these staffing firms today. A very fluid workforce, what we call a non-four-wall exposure. So you have employees across the country. You have employees across different states. You have employees in different regions and locations, in different specific jobs and roles. So it's extremely hard to manage that fluid workforce from a day-to-day perspective at corporate. So making sure the focus is how do I help streamline that? Also, employees tend to be inexperienced and may not really have that close connection to their employer. So when an employee feels like that the employer is not actually there for them and really working for them, that, you know, it allows them to go out and potentially, you know, hire a lawyer when something happened right away. So making sure, again, that focus is there from that upfront employee involvement because people need that connection to their employer. Also from the incident and reporting side, the first line of defense at the branch level is usually a junior hire at the company. And there's also high turnover. So if you don't have a process in place today from a risk management standpoint, there's going to be turnover. The employee might not know what to do. There's not a lot of experience down at that level, but providing and giving them tools to specifically continue to work and allow them to give that company playbook directly to them, that's really easy to use functionality. Businesses also have low margins with no room for unexpected costs. Everyone should be familiar with this if they're in the staffing industry. There are low margins. Making sure that our process is actually really tight and really trying to alleviate and reduce the cost from wherever we can find. Work comp, insurance, risk is a huge driving force to that profitability of that specific firm. Then there's also the managing the complex processes and regulations. You know, even if you're talking about states like California, states like New York, New Jersey, there's so many different processes and regulations involved that it's extremely hard to enforce and making sure that the correct procedures are even happening. So again, making sure that you have a system in place to manage these processes and regulations, all streamlined. And then you're going to be an under-resourced risk management functionalities across all industries. We say risk management teams are often underserved and underutilized, and it really, you know, affects the rest of the business. So giving them, again, tools to help be that outsourced risk manager to all specific locations, even though that they're under-resourced staff, is extremely important. So, you know, from a technology standpoint, today, the usual obstacles that companies are having when selecting any type of technology in their business, if that's from a different applicant tracking system, it's from a system, a risk management system like a claimant. Really, there's a lot of things out there. Definitely hard to select the tool at the end of the day. So finding something that fits the organization at the same time, you know, the cost, the purchase and support is there. A lot of times people don't understand the entire value or the ROI that they're receiving. So that's definitely an obstacle that people are trying to get over on a day-to-day basis when implementing new technologies. There's also the what we call really that one system. Today in the environment, and thanks to technology companies, there have been a lot of integration hassles. So if that's a system that your company has developed in-house from that applicant tracking system, for example, or human resources information system, making sure, again, that you have integrated tools so there's no drop in streamlining this functionality because systems need to speak to each other. That's a huge obstacle if something is built proprietary for one, and then there's a lot of customization involved. At the same time, since the teams are under-resourced most of the time from the corporate perspective, there's really no time to deal with it. How do we actually implement a system? How do we actually actually start to train our employees? Who's going to deal with this? Who's actually going to be that stakeholder that's going to run this process or be that project manager going through and implementing technologies at company? A lot of times there's not a whole lot of budget and working room. Or there's not even a budget that you thought of that, hey, we can actually fit this into an IT budget, or we can fit this in a risk management budget, or we can fit this in an overall corporate budget. Again, another obstacle that people are facing. There's also doubt as to value. Is this actually going to help me better my day-to-day? Where's the ROI from the executive level? How am I going to actually pitch this internally to make sure that that value is there? Not a lot of qualified staff. And then also just not our area of expertise. Some of the really main obstacles today when we're talking with our current clients as well as prospects and when implementing new technologies directly across the staffing space.
So when a technology salesperson or product representative comes your way with a whiz-bang system and you're trying to deal with what do I do? There's so much here. As with any business initiative, you need to quantify what it is you're going to achieve, and you need to justify that the benefits of deploying a technology system are worth all the cost of deployment and the expense of buying and carrying and feeding the tool. So where do you begin? Well, don't let the pursuit of perfection keep you from doing the things that are clearly priorities, would be my recommendation. You've got to do what's right for you under your circumstances. And it would be best to settle on a few things that you know you need to deal with and set them aside as your biggest issues and deal with them first. It's important that your technology tool, and this is the second bullet point, should improve your ability to monitor and measure your cost of risk and your performance against critical risk metrics. If you don't have a quantitative basis to any sort of technology tool that you're trying to deploy, you'll have trouble getting it approved in the first place. You'll have even greater trouble getting it used and used properly so that it achieves the results you wanted it to achieve in the first place. Results can fall into two categories, activity metrics and financial metrics. It's probably best that you have a mix of both, because there are certain things where it's too hard to measure the ultimate financial outcome. But you want to measure activities as long as they are closely related to financial risk and outcomes. For example, getting claims reported fast is a surefire way to reduce the cost of a claim. There's study after study that has proven it over time. I proved it in my own book of business at the staffing company I was associated with. But the relationship is not necessarily one-to-one, but if you bucket all your cases together, you can show a very strong correlation. So that's an example of an activity metric. Other things like financial metrics are cost as a percent of wages, incident rates per 2,000 hours worked, that sort of thing are pretty common. But here's some advice. You want to have metrics that will support the tool, that deal with your biggest risk issues, and that the tool will help you accumulate. Avoid things that require manual data collection. And as the last bullet says, have a preference for metrics that can be tracked over time. So you probably want to end up with a handful of key risk categories, the things that you want to deal with first, because they appear to be your biggest priorities. And then you want to settle on a handful of risk metrics that you can track over time, that are relevant to your financial performance, that you can document and demonstrate to your leadership, that collect data for you, and ideally are linked to your risk appetite and tolerance. What I mean by that is, what's a measure of good performance? What's a measure of unacceptable performance? If you can track things over time, you can compare against yourself, but having some ultimate goal can help drive the cause. So make sure your systems facilitate that. So the ideal solution will be a system that has easy to use technology to streamline risk management, gives you data in real time, and most fundamentally lets you build trust through a collaborative approach. What I mean by that last point is that if risk management remains in the realm of us versus them, of fighting claims, you're only going to get so far. To really have a breakthrough, you want to get everybody on the same page, collaborating toward affirmative results, toward improving safety circumstances and toward identifying incidents beforehand so that we can do something about them to keep incidents from happening. So this is how technology can help you stay ahead of this rush of new problems and new risks and be part of the solution. So Alex is going to show you an example now.
Exactly, and spot on. So bringing it back, as we talked about, really from that technology perspective, focusing on the 3 to 4 buckets, as we call them. So all the way from the proactive piece, as Gary mentioned, from workplace safety. So making sure, again, before a claim or incident does happen, what are we doing today? So you can actually streamline all of workplace safety, if that's an on-site evaluation at a new client site, where an employee can actually walk around with a mobile device, do the specific on-site evaluation instead of doing it by pen and paper, where they can be quote-unquote potentially just pencil whipping the form and going through the motions. So really focusing on that workplace safety mentality, creating everything now digital in one platform, get away from the paper aspect, and then also creating that usable data on the front end. Also focusing really on the incident and claims workflow piece. So all the way from the incident inception, making sure we put easy-to-use tools where an employee can actually report an incident directly on a mobile device, can be begun by the branch manager, building in smart tasks, functionality, specific actionable insights, where as we work through, our goal is to get from that incident to the resolution and claims process as quickly as possible. So building your playbook directly in a system like this. And then finally on the back end is going to be our analytics. So not only will we have analytics on the front end from workplace safety and loss control, but also seeing in real time, marrying it up with that real time incident and claims data, so that you can begin to benchmark, you can begin to trend, you can see specific things happening, have a lot more transparency than just monitoring it directly and entering data on an Excel worksheet, and not having that actionable data to go actually and make a better decisions from a risk management standpoint. So one staffing case study, we've got actually a client who's a 100-person branch staffing firm. The goals were simple. They really wanted to simplify the reporting and documentation from the field, move away from multiple input forms from different systems, and unify the entire process. The results from that is really creating a single digital report that each branch manager, supervisor, and even a client can complete. So the focus is who, what, when, where, why, making sure, again, that employees, branch managers, supervisors have that at their fingertips, make sure that they're reporting it directly in the system. We also incorporated different dependencies within that form to drive information and request follow-ups. So if this incident happened to an individual and it was a contractor, or this incident happened to a specific client site and you want to ask new sets of questions based on those responses, doing things now digitally and not by pen and paper allow people to create different dependencies and workflows based off of them. The guesswork and inconsistency now is replaced by that automated predefined workflows. Instead of saying, oh, this happened at this branch, who do I have to call again? Or going look back onto my 10-page manual guide of when an incident happens at a new branch, what do I do? So there's no more guesswork and that inconsistency is then solved, which with alleviating a lot of that guesswork also happens to when you're putting a playbook in place, allows to reduce the need to train employees. Like we mentioned earlier in the presentation, there's a lot of high turnover. So making sure, again, people know what to do, the playbook is in place, the predefined workflows are already set up. Also, information is now simultaneously available to all stakeholders at all times. So again, if that's from the branch managers, if that's from regional directors or VPs, people can exactly see in transparency the data, what information do I need in a seamless fashion?
So in the world of staffing, as with other businesses, the least expensive case is the one that never happened. So we always want to have an ability to not just deal efficiently with incidents once they do occur, but in the better world, we also have technology that allows us to help us identify hazards to keep incidents from happening in the first place. So with that in mind, the places that are probably the low-hanging fruit in staffing for where this technology can be put to best use is for workplace injuries, which is, of course, post-loss, but also for doing site hazard evaluations, customer site evaluations, and behavioral evaluations before the incidents occur. If you have drivers doing fleet management activity, including start of day walkarounds to verify that safety equipment is in place, that the tires are properly inflated, that sort of thing can be a use of the technology, not just after the accident happens. Apart from workplace injuries, two of your highest volume categories are probably security-related incidents and human resource-related complaints. This can be time card fraud, temporary employees getting into fights, claims of harassment, inappropriate statements, all that sort of thing. You probably have a lot of volume in those areas. Those are probably your areas where you want to start out because you have a lot of volume there and you can get efficiencies through workflow improvement and you can get good metrics to help you understand your own claim data to figure out where it is you want to work. But there are other categories that you'll see on here. Take note of that last one, customer-specific safety partnership programs. This can go beyond just your own use. You can involve other vendors, and you can get into a site-specific relationship with a customer where you can really ingratiate yourself to the customer and make yourself hard to extract if you are working on a deep safety partnership with a specific customer.
So again, a few other specific examples, you know, that as we're going through the entire process and companies that are utilizing workflow tools, systems like ours, really develop a digital process for the on-site evaluation and loss control. Can't stress it enough, extremely important. The goal here is to simplify the safety reporting, the documentation from the field, really move away from that manual input. So today, working on helping standardize evaluation forms, individual safety files and follow-ups from a mobile device, safety dashboard, drilling down by branches, by clients, by location, and policy. And in tandem, as Gary said, that important part is you really want to actually work together with your clients. So we're seeing when people are utilizing technologies and going out to client sites and having that safety-forward focus, that's creating a lot better partnerships. We're here to help continue each other improve. So if you're staffing employees to a specific site that doesn't have great processes or protocols in place, that you can actually really help them from that collaborative standpoint and together to continue to grow business and making sure, again, we're sending our employees to safe environments across the country. Also really, as I talk about it more in depth, is develop that digital process for the incident and claims workflow. Simplify reporting, keep it easy, that documentation from the field, moving away again from the multiple different import forms or and unify the process into all one central digital file. Have all notes, files organized, filtering, incident claim file details all located. Again, having the capabilities to drill down by specific branches, client locations, and different policy types. And then finally, really centralize the claims, feeds from insurance carriers, and analytics all into one digital tool. We're helping companies today organize and clean files from multiple different carriers and TPAs. Again, making sure that we're taking that historical data as well as real-time data. Our team does a lot of the QAing and organizational process in place. So we're able to offer those analytic dashboards, those filtering capabilities, where you can actually drill down by client branch, location, different policy types.
So a couple final observations. Most fundamentally, the tools that we're showing you are examples of technologies that allow you to expand the risk management practice throughout your organization. If you have a couple people dealing with claims, there's probably a limit to your effectiveness. The true breakthroughs can happen when you get your field practitioners to behave differently. So being effective at risk management means that you have tools that now make it feasible and practical for everybody in the organization to have a stake and thereby change the organization's very risk culture because you have the tool that makes that possible. In the course of doing that, you've aligned your interest with parties that may have previously been your adversaries. When you get everybody on the page of how can we become a better risk, then you are truly positioning your organization to grow your business in a safe way and to improve your financial performance. So that's the role that we think technology can play, and the new technologies available to you make that feasible in ways that did not previously exist. So thank you, and we are now available for any questions that anybody may have.
At this time, you can go ahead and submit any questions in the Q&A or the chat feature. We're thinking of any questions that are coming in, would you be able to talk to us a little bit about kind of the biggest questions that you seem to run across with other staffing companies and how you might address them for our group?
Yes, definitely. So I think, you know, a lot of the questions, you know, that and frequently asked questions, you know, from our side is really thing on where the focus starts. So I think from the standpoint of, you know, hey, we're really struggling. What are some of the challenges from actually completing on-site workplace safety and safety evaluations? Which leads to helping us, again, we're struggling with the incident and claims reporting. So a lot of the specific, you know, struggles that are coming are some of those observations that we're seeing. And it's about starting in one place, and let's help solve the specific issue as we go into that process. You know, when we're talking about specifically if there's, hey, we actually don't even know if we have a problem yet, actually diving in into really listening to do some discovery. So how are you actually reporting incidents today? What does your risk management philosophy look like? What are some of the large losses that you've had in the last 5 years? Could those have been alleviated if we put different protocols in place? So there's a lot of starting points that we have with different clients and a lot of different struggles, but at the end of the day, we are allowed to, you know, we create configurable solutions because everyone needs to collect the same information, just in a little bit of a different fashion. So it's really kind of asking to take a look internally, what are some of those really struggle points that we're having and challenges that we're having, and what's keeping us up at night at that staffing firm.
And a second question that might come to my mind would be that the typical staffing firm has some existing technologies that they're using. They may or may not be using their insurance company's claim system. They probably have some sort of front office system, an applicant tracking system, maybe an HR management system. They probably have a bunch of Excel-type files sitting around where they keep historical payroll data. Maybe they're dealing with a nurse case manager. How can we interact with all these? How can we make all this talk to each other? And that's something we didn't really have much time to address in this session. But having those integrations is really critical to success, and it's something that a lot of our customers ask us about very early on. And it's something I would certainly put a high priority on, is the degree to which you can make it easy for systems to talk, where I don't have to do all kinds of manual transfer work.
Exactly.
That's a great point. Yeah, absolutely. And to start small, right? Start with, you know, maybe one thing that you feel is most impactful and work out from there.
Agreed.
To start somewhere, get moving on one thing, and then, you know, tackle the next thing down the road.
You bet.
Exactly. And I also think from that standpoint, we, you know, not only from the risk management teams, as we mentioned, that don't have the largest team or they're underserved. At the same time, staffing firms have limited IT resources. So finding a technology solution that doesn't take up a lot of internal staffing firm technology time. A way to implement resources, making sure you're choosing the correct solution that your technology team doesn't have to focus on actually building, because you'd be surprised. A lot of times you buy a system, and then all of a sudden on-premise your team has to go and do a lot of different work associated with it. So making sure, again, that we bring in-house all that expertise is important, because there are limited resources on the IT side.
Correct. Right. Okay, well, as we kind of wrap things up here, are there any final takeaways that you'd like to share with the audience that you feel are most impactful out of today's session?
Gary, do you want to jump in on final takeaways?
I'm good, thank you.
Yeah, I think from our standpoint, please reach out if anyone has any questions. TRICOM's got our initial contact information and emails. We'd love to talk to people. We've got a deep experience in the staffing space. And if you just want to be a sounding board, we're more than happy to do that as well. Looking forward to continue to go down the technology journey with a lot of our clients. And please reach out. We'd love to touch base with anyone who's interested.
Sounds great. And I've gone ahead and put my contact information up. Feel free to reach out to me, and we can get you connected with Alex or Gary if you have further questions or would like additional information. Thank you all for joining us on the webinar today. And certainly, Gary and Alex, thank you for sharing your knowledge of leveraging technology to manage risk in real time. Watch for information on our next webinar session. Have a great day, everyone.
Thank you, Amanda.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.